Okay, in this video, I want to take a look at a new model called InternLM, and actually specifically to look at InternLM 2.5 in here. So I haven't come across InternLM before, but a lot of people have been talking about the new version of this, so I thought I'd take a look at it. But the thing that makes this model so interesting is the whole sort of promise of if we can have a model that is kind of built for doing agents, meaning that it is optimized for function calling, it can handle JSON well, it can handle a bunch of these things, then do we get something that actually allows us to do a lot better sort of local agents when we're using a quantized version of this? So let's have a look at the model itself, and then I'll also go through and test it out for some things like function calling, both in the high resolution version of the model on Hugging Face and also on Ollama to see how it's going to stand up there. So this is out of the Shanghai AI lab in collaboration with SenseTime. So SenseTime is a big Chinese AI company that mostly specializes in computer vision stuff in the past, but it seems like they've been involved in this for LLMs, perhaps providing some of the compute, etc. But it turns out that this is not the first InternLM. So this is actually version 2.5. And when we look at their site, we can see that they've actually been working on a bunch of different ones. The idea here with this group is it seems that they've been working on math and reasoning and stuff like that. And that's what's been the precursor that's led to the Intern 2.5 model. So currently, as I'm recording this, InternLM 2.5 is actually the number one model on Hugging Face for anything below 10 or 12 billion parameters in here. So this is a 7 billion parameter model, and it seems to be outperforming Llama 3 and Gemma 2, as well as a bunch of other open source models that people have put up there as well. So let's look at some of the details about it. So while it seems it's a reasonably open license for academics and stuff like that, and commercial use is allowed, you do have to apply on a form to actually get the commercial use in here. Okay, so what are the new things that make this stand out? So first off, like I mentioned, this is currently topping the Hugging Face leaderboards in here. And the big thing that they're emphasizing is the whole math reasoning, that this is surpassing models like Llama 3 and Gemma 2 9 billion. Now, this may change with the Phi-3 model doing extremely well. I'll do another video about that model. It currently looks like there might be something wrong with the evaluation on that for one of the data sets in there. But overall, clearly the model is doing very well. Now, the other things that are really interesting in here is that it's got a million context window. And they're claiming that this is getting nearly perfect at finding the whole sort of needle in a haystack thing that we've looked at multiple times on here, as well as doing well on long bench. Now, one of the things that I think is really interesting in here is not just the actual model itself that they've released, they've also released a framework to deploy this. So this is built on top of Hugging Face, I think. And looking at it, it's got a simple way of doing this. But one of the cool things too that they've done is they've got a way of where you can pass off for long context. So one of the big challenges with, if you've got a million context window, is you need a lot of VRAM to just run it. Most people find that they're struggling to have enough VRAM to hit 100K. So it looks like what they've done here is that they've basically made this framework so it allows them to transfer off to the disks for doing this offline inference when you're doing a really long context window. So this is cool to see that they've done this. And I wonder, will we see this something like this folded into Hugging Face in the near future? Anyway, on top of the 1 million context window, the other thing that they've also emphasized here is the whole area around stronger tool use, function calling, all the sort of agentic things that we're interested in. So it does look like this model has been specifically trained to do some of these things. So this is stronger at tool use, at function calling. Interestingly, also, they talk about the whole idea of reflection, right? So this is, I think, one of the first times that's specifically emphasizing reflection as one of the things. Certainly, instruction following and tool selection are really good. Now, on top of this, they've also released this framework called Lagent. I guess that's how you say it. I'm not sure. But the idea here is that this is like an agentic framework that's made to use this particular model. And they have some nice examples in here of showing like function calling and that the model can return things in JSON to be able to do function calling stuff, just like we would expect from most models like this. And I do think it's really interesting that they've built this agentic framework perhaps around the model, right? This is something that kind of is quite different from what we're seeing from LangChain and Llama Index and other sort of things where they're trying to support all models. It's interesting to see that if you build something directly for the model, are you going to be able to get better responses out of it? Because we know that one of the big things that limits a lot of agentic uses is that, you know, prompts actually change from model to model. So if something like this has been optimized for this model, I think that alone is a really interesting fact in here. So what's Lagent? It's a lightweight open source framework that allows for efficiently building large language model based agents. And it talks about some tool use and stuff like that. And you can see here that, okay, we can see exactly how they've architected this. They've got a whole sort of examples in here as well. So this certainly looks like it can end up being a really strong companion to go along with the model in here. So looking at the model benchmarks here, we can see that the model is definitely benchmarking very well against, you know, Llama 3. We can see the fine tune is also doing very well against other fine tunes and stuff like that in here. So the cool thing is they have released both a fine tune chat version, a fine tune chat 1 million version on Hugging Face, but they've also released the base model as well. So I would expect that we're going to see some nice fine tunes from other people. And now that a lot of these function calling data sets are starting to get out there, we're starting to see some of the fine tunes be able to do really well with that. So if this has had pre-training for this already, it's going to be really good to see how well that does with extra fine tuning. So looking at their tech report quickly, it's definitely, you know, if you're interested in finding out what they're doing, you know, it's definitely a more detailed tech report than many. This is the tech report for the version 2, which was only a 200K context window. I don't know if they're going to update it for 2.5. I do hope so, because they've put a lot of effort into explaining exactly what they've done with the fine tuning, but also the data selection. So one of the things that most of the tech reports are not including now is exactly where the data came from, what were the percentage splits, this kind of thing. So you can see here, they're talking a lot about common crawl, about the book data set, that kind of thing. But also we've got things like this where they really break down that they're using a data set of 10 million instructions for the instruction tuning data set. And then we can actually see that 18% of that is math. 16% is NLP tasks. 50% is conversation. So this is really nice to actually see this. And especially for those of us interested in fine tuning, just get a sense of what other people are doing. Unfortunately, Meta and Google with Llama and Gemma in their tech reports are not giving as detailed information as you're finding in here. Another thing that was really interesting in here was the whole sort of conditional reward models. So they show that, you know, this is what Llama 2 did, was they had two reward models for doing this, where they've broken out a bunch of different reward models. So you've got like the helpful and harmless, which is the sort of the typical thing that the Llama people popularize. But here you've also got math, you've got code going into these as well. And again, we've got details about the data composition for the reward model as well. Overall, a very interesting paper to check out and see what they were thinking, what they actually did. A lot more detail than what we've seen from a lot of the other models that have come out. As with most things now, they've released the models on Hugging Face. You can, you know, try it out. Also released, you know, a bunch of other things here and details about this. All right, on top of all of this, the model is also out on Ollama, so you can get started and use it there. So let's jump into the code, have a look at how the model actually performs, and then also perhaps have a look at trying to do something agentic with it locally through Ollama. Okay, so I'm going to go through two lots of code. I'm going to go through the Hugging Face implementation, and then I'm also going to go through Ollama's implementation as well in here. Okay, so just before I get started on the Hugging Face one, if you do want to use the LMDeploy one, you can just take their code and run it in here. Now you will, if you're doing it in Colab, because it's using async, you basically need to import the nest async IO first and apply that. But then it will basically load up the model, you can run it through. You will need to do your own sort of tokenization and stuff like that in here. But it is quite nice that when I ask it in here, okay, please intro yourself in English. If I ask it, just intro itself, it gives me a Chinese intro. But here it basically tells us a little bit about itself. We've got conversational model developed by Shanghai AI Lab. A primary function is to use to generate human-like text. So it's nice that they've actually fine-tuned this in here. A lot of the models don't do that, which I often find weird in here. All right, so the Hugging Face version, I'm going to go through quite quickly. The thing I'm going to focus on here is mostly I want to talk about the function calling, using that in Hugging Face and using the function calling in Ollama as well, if you want to try and do stuff there. All right, so here we can see that, okay, I'm just loading up the model. You need to make sure you've got trust remote code equals true. They do download a couple of things for the tokenizer and stuff like that. In the tokenizer, they've got some, you know, interesting tokens in there for other things as well. Also, obviously, because they've made it the model bilingual, they've made a tokenizer that's got a lot of Chinese tokens in there as well. And we can see that when we look at the tokenizer size, that it is an unusual size, right? Because of this, because it's got the sort of Chinese and English stuff in here as well. I haven't tested it for other multilingual stuff. I'm not sure. I don't think it's massively trained for multilingual things, languages and stuff in here. All right, so I've just got a basic setup for this. If we look at the outputs, we can see that the outputs are quite good. One of the things I found interesting is that it definitely has its own feel. Whether you like that or don't like that, I guess really depends on your personal preference. But for example, when I ask it the question, the standard question about llama, vicuna, and alpaca, it makes this list of, okay, I'm going to identify the animals, llama, vicuna, and alpaca. And then for each one, it gives something in this. Whereas in the past, a lot of the models would say, okay, llamas, then give me all the details for llamas. Vicunas, give me all the details for vicunas. Alpacas, give me all the details there. Here, it's not doing that. It's basically doing, okay, compare physical characteristics, compare their uses. And each time it's got one sentence for llamas, one for vicunas, one for alpacas in there, which just highlights the differences in the model in here. It does quite a nice job at doing the emails. So looking out at the emails and stuff like that, we get some nice results back. I like the interesting thing with the one from the young kid is that there's a big use of emojis in here. Something that we saw that the latest Gemma models could use emojis and take advantage of that. But this is also doing that with obviously a much smaller model than 27 billion. Anyway, it handles each of these quite nicely. And most of the answers that we get are pretty sort of standard. It's not great on the succinct stuff of getting to the point, but most of these other ones it gets right. Creative writing is actually better than I thought it would be, given the fact that this is focusing on math and stuff like that. The GSM 8K, it clearly does pretty well here. So we've got, okay, the first one's pretty simple. We can see it does the rounding nicely on this one. We can see that it gets the whole sort of 121 is the key thing, which is the correct answer in here. And it gets it both when it does it with text and when it does it with math. The React prompting, it clearly knows about what React prompting is and is able to do that. What I find more interesting, though, is that it does actually come with this interesting kind of format. If we look at their chat format, we've got a standard kind of sort of normal thing. But the cool thing is they've also put in like the whole function call format of that. You can see that you basically pass in a name equals plugin. And then whenever you pass this in, it is going into being able to return function calling in here. So you can see this is an example of what it returns as we go through it. So let's look at that in the code. So here I'm basically constructing the prompt, and I'm not going to use the Hugging Face chat tokenizer where it's pre-made for that, because that is not made for using with the function calling. But we can see that here we're basically passing in the exact same thing, and we're getting up to this output here. All right, we then have a function for basically running this, and we decode that back. And you can see, sure enough, what do we get back but a function call. So we can see that, okay, it's basically passing back that it needs to get current weather. So from that, we can then pass that out quite nicely. So we just run this through. So this, for example, would be what you get back in this case. We can pass that out. And then if we set up like a fake little get current weather API, this is going to return a fixed response. We can then execute that and basically go through the whole thing and go from getting the function call to actually running the function, getting the response back. And then we would take this and we'd pass this back into the LLM for a final output in here. So this sort of prompting format, the way they've set up this function calling is quite nice that they've actually made this available. This also allows us to do this in Ollama as well, which is the one I'm going to look at next. Okay, so if we come into Ollama here, so we could do this with both LangChain or without. I'll start off doing a couple with LangChain, but then I'm going to show you the sort of manual way of doing this. So if we wanted to do something like just plain JSON, getting some JSON out, we just want to pass in the InternLM2, which is actually the 2.5 model in there. And if we run that, you'll see that it will return its response in JSON. Oh yeah. Now, if we actually prompt it with the system, we can actually tell it don't prefix response or don't explain anything, and we'll just get the JSON out. It's actually quite good at, the model is quite good at that. The next thing that we can do is do like extraction. So now we're passing a JSON schema into this, where it's going to basically pull out name, age, favorite food. And it does a reasonably good job at this. We want to basically tell it to just don't prefix, don't give any explanation. And you can see that, okay, John, who is 35, loves pizza. We get name, age, doesn't comply with fave food. So that's one thing it got wrong. It says hobbies, eating pizza, rather than favorite food there. I think that you can work with this in the prompts. And actually, personally, I think doing it without LangChain is better in here. So let me come in here and just show you. So here we're basically passing in the prompt, and we've got two ways we can actually do this. The first way is if we do pass it in just in the messages in here, you'll see that what we get out has this content where we've got the actual call for this as well. So we could actually go in there. So you can see if I just change that to that the print is only printing that out. Now we just get out the name of the function to call, the parameters going for the function. So that's doing it with the message format in here. The other thing you can do is you can actually do it with the generate format, where here we can basically just run this in, I run the same thing again. And sure enough, what do we get out? We get out the name, get current weather, parameters, location, Singapore, etc. So from this, you can use the same functions I put in the Colab notebook to actually pass this, extract it out, and call the function that you want to do. So you've got your extract there, and then you've got your calling there, and then you would just feed this back in for this. So it does show that we could actually do some nice things with function calling on Ollama using this model. It seems to be, you know, working reasonably well. And I notice that, and the key thing here is I haven't really played around with the system prompt too much. I noticed that definitely playing with the system prompt, you can get it to pay attention more to some of the things that you're passing in and stuff like that as well. So that's something you could probably do to get even better results with this. Anyway, overall, this model is very interesting. If you're looking for an open source model for doing things like function calling, like some of the math stuff, some of the reasoning stuff in here, you've got something that can certainly process these both in a full resolution mode in Colab, but also with Ollama locally on your machine, 7 billion model, very quick, very responsive for getting the kind of results that you want out for building little agents that, you know, can do stuff here. So have a play with it. Let me know what you think in the comments. As always, if you've got any questions or anything like that, put them in the comments below. If you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe. And I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.